I've noticed that Crocodile Hunter is so important because it really brings wildlife into your living room, into your house. You experience it. It's not watching something on the long lens, hey?
Exactly, and the amazing thing about it too is it doesn't date. So when you watch it now, you're like, it's still like you watched it yesterday, and that's what I love about it.
We're traveling on an island trading boat through a remote part of the Indonesian archipelago to the last surviving stronghold of the world's biggest lizard.
Check this place out, unbelievable. This is the home of the dragon.
We're north of Australia and west of Papua New Guinea, traveling around a few tiny scraps of land that make up Komodo National Park. Only one of these islands is big enough to appear on a map of the world.
Komodos are only found on a handful of islands. This is remote, it's really remote, hence the wild boat trip. Have a go at the welcoming committee. Check this out. Ooh. Welcome to the islands.
When you visit the dragons, known locally as auras, you'll always be under the watchful eyes of wildlife rangers. Steve is very experienced with crocodiles, snakes, lizards, all reptiles, so he's allowed some freedom.
Oh. Woo-hoo. Komodo dragon welcoming party. Holy smokes, this is gonna be an adventure. Excuse me. As I try to weave my way past the welcoming committee, I spot a couple of huge dragons feeding in the mangroves. And I didn't know it, but dragons frenzy feed. They see me, which triggers a food response, and they rush straight at me, trying to get my calf muscles and my thighs. If they connect, they're gonna make me bleed, and then it's all over bar to shout. They just keep coming straight at me. No, 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 no! Get hideously out. Dangerous. One bite and I'm gone.
Get out! Back off, get out!
Holy smokes, that was too close.
Hey, yeah!
Let's follow them. I've been allowed to get right in close to the lizard, but they are dangerous. In a food response, they could kill, and that's why it's important for visitors to travel with rangers.
The locals call this dragon Baras, and he's an enormous Komodo. He's been scavenging near the water. Where the fishermen have set lines, he's taken advantage of the fish. But unfortunately, he's gotten the hook right down his throat, and now Steve's got to help him out, or it could cost the lizard his life.
And it isn't that easy. I've got to try and get out in front of the lizard and pull the fishing line so as the hook and all pops straight out of his mouth. Got it. Oh, great. Now he gets aggressive. Oh, no, his aggression's turned to a food response. He's on me. He's going to try and bite my calf muscle. He's on. He's wired. He's going to grab me. I've got to run for cover. Woo, straight up a tree. Look at this. He's going to take my calf muscle straight out. And if he locks down, I'll bleed out and die. The tree's my only chance. In such short distance, he'd outrun me and grab me easily.
Unbelievable. He's just clicked. This is a great demonstration of how dangerous they are. How's this? Check this out. Look at that. That's one tooth. One tooth straight through my leather boots, straight through the Gore-Tex, into the sock. Look at that. He's sitting there, eh? He's like in sensory overload. Holy smokes. Whoo! Danger, danger, danger. Unbelievable. I'm just gonna ease myself out of this tree.
He's on to me. He's staring straight at me. I'm gonna have to be really careful and get ready to run, because there's blood in the air. And if he senses that, he'll attack again.
That was amazing.
We're out of here, come on.
Whoa.
That was close. That was really, really close.
And I still have that boot. I have the boot.
Do you really?
Yeah, I have the boot that got split by the Komodo dragon, and it just went through the leather like butter.
That's amazing. And yet, once in captivity, they're like beautiful,
They're like dogs.
Gorgeous sock. You can hug them and kiss them.
Yeah.
Kiss them on the lips.
I remember when Bindi was little and she'd go in with the Komodo dragon here at Australia Zoo and she'd hug on it and kiss it.
When you see them in the wild, it's a very different story.
And if you read the textbooks, the really big ones can't climb trees. So someone forgot to show that Komodo dragon the textbook.
Yeah, did you see how high he got?
Oh, yeah, not a problem.
No, just whoop, straight up.
Yep, textbook wrong.
What an amazing animal.
That was cool.
Oh, I love Komodos.
Sunrise. In the islands is always a classic time. All of the nocturnal animals, the deer and the buffalo, they start to seek refuge. They don't want to be out and about and in an area where they could get ambushed by a Komodo. Here we go. Dragon poo. Now, like all goannas or most large goannas, large monitors, their poo is very significant. Not only is it significant to me, the researcher, but it's also significant to other dragons. This poo will tell another dragon exactly what's going on. Perfect, absolutely perfect. That's another dragon's claw, and I can tell by this, well, the dragon that this big one ate was probably around about 4 feet, 3.5 to 4 feet. So he would have grabbed, lacerated, killed the little dragon, swallowed it down whole.
The droppings tell us this is a big dragon's home range. They mark their territory, and the sunny side of the slope is where we'll find it, getting the body temperature up for the day's hunting.
Have a look at the size of this. He's a beauty. There's a good boy. He's got some really heavy-duty scars on his back from territorial disputes with other Komodos. They bite each other on the tail and the back. Have a look at those feet. Bigger than my hands. What a reptile. Yes, this is one of the ruling reptiles. You can see why they're immense. Absolutely immense. I just take my time, nice and steady. Nice and steady. I tell you what, this is really intimidating. I'm just watching his back feet. At the moment, he's quite relaxed. Komodos, like all goannas, they're ambush predators. And within their own body length, they're faster than I could ever move. He'd have teeth like a tiger shark.
The Komodo dragons are from the same family as the Australian goannas and other monitor lizards, or varanids. Don't let that lumbering dinosaur walk fool you. These guys can switch on a real sprint and hit almost 12 miles an hour when they hunt their prey. The Komodo's body language is saying, "Stay away from me." There's that curled tail ready to snap out with incredible force.
Wow. Have you ever met anyone who can make poo exciting?
No, it was pretty exciting, actually.
Yeah, I know.
It was like, you know, a treasure hunt, like looking for Easter eggs Sunday morning.
It's amazing. He can even talk about poo and it's exciting. But
it's how cool.
Really good way to actually know what... Goannas are very territorial, or monitors are very territorial, so they'll actually do these poos in certain areas to let other monitors know. So when you're in an area, you can actually... Like out at Windora.
Yeah.
And you go to certain areas and there's parenti poo put in little spots so you can get an idea of the population numbers and size.
It's and what's weird is they seem to triangulate.
Mm.
So it's always that triangle formation for the poo.
Yep.
It's fascinating.
And you can tell how big they are. You can tell a lot by poo.
You can. And it's less scary.